snowy back roads of eastern Ukraine lead to the front lines of this ongoing war between the National Army and Russian-backed separatists. They get to the front in a converted and battered old ambulance. This isn't a high-tech army. Our journey took us through the heavily mined countryside. The red signs warned the danger of leaving the road. The separatist positions run parallel to us all the way. We're with the 24th Battalion of the Ukrainian Army. They're taking us to a village closed to the outside world. Only 11 of the original 200 inhabitants remain. It's not near the front line. It is actually the front line. There's fighting here all the time.
The shooting is virtually constant. It's late miles being stretched as well. That's what fighting is for the fourth ever. Every single day, the bomb has sent to this hour. The shooting in this hour, the wall, the build up for years now. I'm trying to pull the money, but we're still fighting there.
After 8 years at the center of this war, there's not much left of Novo Alexandrovka. The houses are battered and largely empty. The soldiers say that most of those who remain stay indoors, particularly in winter. A 73-year-old Elena welcomed us inside. She told us how all of her windows were smashed by bombs during the worst fighting. It is so bad at times she lies next to her brick oven for protection. Clutching her important documents, prepared to run if she has to. There's no electricity, no shops or medical services. She's got nowhere to go. More importantly, she doesn't want to go. To put it simply, Elena is tougher than all of us.
What do you mean,
from their overwatch positions on the roofs of houses in the village, the soldiers keep a continuous eye on the separatist positions about 100 meters away. They say they've been at war for 8 years already and rarely, if ever, discuss a Russian invasion, although they accept it could happen. Along a 250-mile demarcation, two sides day and night escaped fire from the next hour. Beneath ground, the job of preparing and fighting never stops. A bloody 8-year conflict could be a massacre, but worse. Stu Rouse's guy used, he's
talking about. No insurance?
Who's got the best fans?
That's a very good question.
Let's put on the ball.
I'm on it, but
Terry Orton was the Webex.
The Clarinet One team and the Clarinets are competing like never before. Webex, driving hybrid work.
And instead just force a change of government from one that opposes the Kremlin to one that supports it. The White House National Security Council saying in a statement overnight, this kind of plotting is deeply concerning. The Ukrainian people have the sovereign right to determine their own future, and we stand with our democratically elected partners in Ukraine. Now, Russia, of course, is denying these allegations, calling them disinformation, and Pope Francis today calling for an international day of prayer for peace in Ukraine. President Biden, meanwhile, has been huddling at Camp David with his national security officials. Remember, the president has said he will not deploy U.S. troops to Ukraine to fight there, but he is sending missiles and other equipment to the Ukrainians to help them defend themselves in the event of an invasion. But of course, there is always the danger that if America's NATO allies get roped into the fighting, then the U.S. would be obligated under treaty to come to their defense. Will it?
Raf Sanchez started off top with the luck of this morning. Raf, thanks so much.
Hey, thanks for watching on YouTube.
Thank you. Here in Ukraine, the uncertainty remains whether Vladimir Putin is still preparing to attack. And if it never opposed the diplomacy in Geneva, Russia, though, is still sending more troops to the border.
This morning, Ukrainian soldiers are watching and waiting in the snowy trenches in eastern Ukraine. Just across the border, Russian forces conducting military exercises.
There's no sign of de-escalation here.
High stakes talks in Geneva continue to progress in Russia. May have been supported. They've not dispelled the fear of a Russian invasion.
If in fact they commit another incursion to Ukrainian territory, they're just going to set themselves up for even more isolation from the rest of the international community. This is not a country that has a whole lot of friends.
Russia is still demanding a guarantee of the U.S. The U.S. began ruling out that demand, and Russia rattling its saber just before that meeting, holding a joint naval drill in the northern Indian Ocean between China and Iran. One of Ukraine's top commanders to the east, Lieutenant General Alexander Pavlov, says Ukraine has placed there now a total of 27,000 Russian troops advancing through the border. He says his country needs more American weapons to deter Putin. The U.S. is rushing more military aid to Ukraine. These photos have an unsure the first shipment of a $200 million package landed in Kiev, which includes about £200,000 worth of aid, including ammunition. Country's troops have been dug in among bombshells and buildings now located in the invisible Russian controls and disrupted. Any invasion would come through here. ABC's in panel going into the trenches. Gunshots ring out in the distance. At the Ukrainian front line, they say all they can do is be ready. Only the Kremlin knows what comes next in this crisis.
Do you think there's a bigger chance of us fighting away?
Basically, yeah, we think that there is a good chance of this.
Generally, he said they are less convinced than the U.S. that the threat of a major Russian attack is real, but they certainly believe the Kremlin is trying to destabilize and pressure the country. The question now, though, is what will Russia do next week when it receives its written responses from the U.S.? With
so much at stake, Patrick Riebel on the ground there in Ukraine, of course. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out.